Hey, welcome to Theology Cafe. My name is Peter. Let's get started. Are we free? Welcome back. Take a moment to subscribe to my channel. Right now, I've got a book giveaway going, which I announced in my last video. Go ahead and check out that for some more details about how to enter. Now, today we're talking about Calvinism. Are we free? Are the choices that we make really ours? Or are they predestined from eternity past, before the foundation of the world? Theologians and even philosophers have been discussing this for millennia. The idea that we are predestined, the idea that we don't have any free will, is not a new one. There's a rising group of what some call neo-Calvinists, but this is not a new idea at all. In Christianity, there are three main ways of thinking about God's sovereignty and man's free will. These three normally go by the names Calvinism, Arminianism, and open theism. In the next three videos, we are going to discuss what these three ways of thinking are, what they say about us, and what they say about God. Now, it's important to remember there is a broad range of beliefs even within these three camps. So I am going to do my best to describe pure Calvinism, pure Arminianism, and pure open theism. And then in the fourth video, I'm going to discuss my views on these three ideas, and I'm going to do a Q&A. So start thinking of questions. If you are a Patreon subscriber, you will get preference on this Q&A section. Today we're going to be talking about Calvinism. And I want to remind you that these are not necessarily my beliefs. And so I'm going to outline what Calvinists believe without being biased. Now, I know that's not totally possible, but I'm going to do my best to honor each of these systems. These are things that should not tear us apart, but unfortunately have. There is a growing movement within the US known as Neo-Calvinism. It's this new spring from an old idea. In fact, the ideas of Calvinism are older than the 16th century theologian that it's named after. Within Christianity, these ideas go all the way back to Augustine of Hippo. Calvinistic thought within Christianity began with Augustine of Hippo, and Calvin doesn't deny this. Calvin, in many of his works, actually references Augustine. Augustine brought these ideas into Christianity against the ideas of a man named Pelagius, who believed in complete free will. Calvinism, at its core, boasts as being God-centric, that God's sovereignty is exalted above everything else. John Calvin has many writings in which he details these beliefs, but it wasn't until later that his students put it into the form that we find it today, which is known as the Five Points of Calvinism, or TULIP. So what does Calvinism say about the world that we live in and the God that we serve? Number one, total depravity. This is the belief that man is totally bad, that man is totally selfish, and that man could not seek God on his own. This is not to say that people can't do good things, but simply that they cannot choose God on their own. That God has to choose them first and regenerate them before they're able to choose God back. A couple of scriptures that Calvinists use to back this up, I will put right here as references. But one of these is Mark 7:21-23. And so I'm gonna read that. For from within, out of people's hearts come evil thoughts, sexual immoralities, thefts, murders, adulteries, greed, evil actions, deceit, self-indulgent, envy, slander, pride, and foolishness. All these evil things come from within and defile a person. Point number two, unconditional election. Calvinism believes that from the foundation of the world, God chose people called the elect to receive salvation. God would reach out to these people and select them for his purpose. He would save these people out of their sins. And most Calvinists take this on an individual level, that God selected individual people and said, you will be saved. You will hear the gospel, the Holy Spirit will regenerate you, and you will accept Christ. Some of the scriptures that Calvinists use to back this up, I will put right here. But one of them is Ephesians 1, 4-8. For he chose us in him before the foundation of the world to be holy and blameless in love before him. He predestined us to be adopted as sons through Jesus Christ himself. Jesus Christ for himself, according to the good pleasure of his will, to the praise of his glorious grace that he lavished on us in the Beloved One. Point number three, limited atonement. Now this is the belief that the people that God chose, Jesus died only for those people. It's the belief that Jesus died only for the elect and not for anyone else. And so practically, a Calvinist cannot go up to someone and say, Jesus died for you, or if you repent and believe, you'll be baptized, because they don't know if Jesus actually died for them. It's not a real offer. Calvinists use these scriptures to back that up. One of them is John 17:9. I pray for them. I am not praying for the world, but for those you have given me, because they are yours. They extrapolate this to say that Jesus only prays for those whom he died for. And in that way, it's only the elect that Jesus died for. Point number four is irresistible grace. Now, this is the belief that if God has chosen you, you have no choice but to accept that grace. God's grace is irresistible. Some of the scriptures that they use to back this up are right here. One of them is John 1:12. But to all who did receive him, he gave them the right to be children of God. To those who believe in his name, who were born not of natural descent, or of the will of the flesh, or of the will of man, but of God. And finally, number five, perseverance of the saints. This one is better known under the name once saved, always saved. And this is following these other four. If God chose you, you can't reject him. And so once you're saved, you will always be saved. There's a popular quote out there by John MacArthur that says, if you could lose your salvation, you would. And this is that idea, that we are so depraved that we need Jesus to save us. We need Jesus to reach out and say, come follow me. And you cannot resist that call. Perseverance of the saints, put simply, is those God chooses, he will sustain and bring them into his kingdom. Calvinists use a variety of scriptures to back this up. These are some of them. One of them that they use is this. Jesus says, I give them, speaking of the people he saves, eternal life, and they will never perish. No one will snatch them out of my hands. My Father who has given them to me is greater than all. No one is able to snatch them out of the Father's hand. So that is the basic, very basic overview of the 5 points of Calvinism. There has been a lot written on this, and even some great videos, which I will link in the description. Calvinism is a complex way of understanding God. Many Calvinists point to Romans 9 and John 6 for a lot of what they get about their belief system. Give those a read, consider what they're saying, and evaluate for yourself. Is this what the Bible says about God? Does it fit the meta-narrative of Scripture? Another note, many Calvinists call themselves 4-point Calvinists, which is to say they believe 4 out of the 5 points. And usually they drop limited atonement because there's a decent amount of scripture, which I will be going over in the Arminianism video, for unlimited atonement. I'm gonna link some really great resources in the video description, ways of understanding Calvinism. And we have to remember that if you are Calvinist, Arminian, or even open theist, we are brothers in Christ. We all believe that God is totally sovereign. And this should not be something that divides us as much as it does. Let's put down our hate and love one another. Let's listen to each other. Hey, thanks for watching. Make sure you hit that like button. Comment down below, what do you believe about Calvinism, Arminianism, and open theism? And make sure you are subscribed so that you can get updates every time I post a video. Hit that little bell. I'll see you next time.
Thanks.